Guys, this is a 2017 question paper for 14 marks. Please take this question in a book and read carefully, and it helps you when I am solving it on the board. Question number 8. Not question number 7, it's question number 8. Okay? Guys, this is a 2017 question paper. We'll read quickly. C Limited is a company in which public are substantially interested. It showed a net profit of ₹7,50,000 during 2015-16. Make it 2018-19. Scrutiny of the accounts revealed the following. Debit to profit and loss account. Debit to profit and loss account means already debited to the profit and loss account. And these expenses were deducted from the net profits. Now we have to see whether these items which comes in the pro forma of taxable income from business calculations. Donation paid to approved public charitable trust, provision for income tax, family planning expenses, capital expenditure on family planning, and credits to profit and loss. Means these are the incomes which is already included in the net profit, and we have to find out what are the incomes which are not related to business, that is non-business incomes. Bad debts allowed earlier recovered during the previous year, 10,000. Interest on bank deposits, 30,000. Long-term capital gain, 1 lakh. Dividend from Indian company, 20,000. There was an unabsorbed depreciation of 35,000 and unabsorbed capital loss of 40,000 brought forward from the earlier assessment year. Compute total income and tax liability of the company for the assessment year 2016-17. So instead of 16-17, make it 19-20. Okay. Now, after reading this question, what we understood is we need to calculate the tax liability. So when you want to calculate tax liability, first we have to find out what is the income from business, income from house property, income from business, capital gains, and income from other sources. That means we should get total income. In order to get the total income, first what we have to find out, what is the taxable income from the business of the C Limited. Now let us calculate or compute the taxable income from business here. So first the computation of taxable income from business. Okay, now guys, we have written the computation of income from business pro forma. Let's read the first. We have to take net profit as per profit and loss account is 7,50,000 rupees. So this is a base for us. Next, we have to look it into debits to profit and loss account. What is debit to profit and loss account? Say debit to profit and loss account means some of the expenses or all the expenses which are debited to profit and loss account. What is the meaning of debited? Means from the profits we have deducted expenses. So in those expenses, we have to identify what are the non-business expenses. What are the non-business expenses? As we have discussed, donations paid to approved public charitable trust. Donations is an inadmissible or a non-business expenses. So donations is 20,000 rupees. Provision for income tax. Provision for income tax. 1 lakh. And then family planning expenses. See guys, family planning expenses is a admissible and it is a business expenses. See, any expenses or any family expenses in revenue in nature. Revenue means what? Regularly incurring in business. such expenditure we consider it as a business. But you know that one more point is that capital expenditure on family planning. See, any capital expenditure spent on family planning, 1/5 of the total expenses will be allowed as a business expenses, and remaining 4/5 will be considered as a non-business. So therefore, we take capital expenditure on family planning. On family planning, see, total 1 lakh rupees is there. In this, 4/5 is 80,000 rupees is inadmissible in nature. Please find out, is there any other expenses? No other expenses we have. Now, what is the second heading for us in second item is business income not credited. See, any income which is related to business not credited, you will find in the adjustment, but we don't have any incomes as such, incomes in the adjustment. We will write it as a nil. And no information about opening stock and closing stock, I'm taking it as a nil. Now, if you check the totals, you will get 2 lakh rupees. If you add 2 lakh rupees to 7 lakh 50, you will get 9 lakh 50,000 rupees. From this income, I mean total profit, we have to deduct certain items. That is, credits to profit or loss account, if you look. We have non-business incomes. Say non-business incomes, which is already credited to the profit and loss account. Those incomes which you are already credited to the profit and loss account, we have to find out that. What are those is, bad debts allowed earlier recovered during the previous year, 10,000. Say, when the bad debt is recovered, which is recorded in the books in the last year, means last year we have taken it as a business loss, such business loss is recovered during the year. So last year it was a loss, business loss, now it is a business income. Please don't take it, because we should take only non-business. Interest on bank deposits, definitely it is a non-business. So interest on bank deposits is 30,000 rupees. And next is long term capital gain 1 lakh rupees. And dividend from Indian company, also non-business. Dividend from Indian company, 20,000. Okay, now these are the some of the expenses. Now what we have to do? We are done with all the incomes part. Now business expenses not debited, second heading. So we don't have any as such business expenses which is not debited, because all such items to find in the adjustments, and the adjustments we don't have. Under valuation of opening stock and over valuation of closing stock, we don't have anything. Now, the next point is, in the adjustment if you read, there was an unabsorbed depreciation of 35,000. Say, what is the meaning of unabsorbed depreciation? Say, depreciation which we could not deduct it in the last year's profit. So, such depreciation we have carried forward for the next year, or it can be carried forward for 8 successive previous years. So, that means to say that the depreciation loss what we had in the last year, that is carried forward for the this year or to the next year. That next year is nothing but our year. So, since there was not sufficient profits to deduct 35,000 rupees of depreciation, that was brought forward into the current previous year. So, therefore, first we will take unabsorbed depreciation of 35,000 rupees. And if you have any brought forward unabsorbed losses as per the books, even brought forward unabsorbed depreciation also should be as per the books only. And if you have any brought forward unabsorbed losses as per the books also, we have to take it. But if you read second point, B point in the adjustment, unabsorbed capital losses is 40,000 rupees brought forward from the earlier assessment. C, see, here we have to take only the business losses but not the capital losses. So therefore, we cannot provide capital losses here. We should take only the business losses. See, if you incur any losses in the last year, and such losses if you cannot set off from any of the heads of the income, okay, such losses can be carried forward for 8 successive previous years, right? So since we don't have, okay, any capital, I mean to say the business losses, so there is no need to deduct it. And if you check the total, it becomes 1,85,000 rupees. How much? 1,85,000. If you deduct 9,50,000 minus 1,85,000, you get 14 minus 6, 8 minus 1, 7. So this is called as income, taxable income from business. And what is the next computation for us is computation of total income. Computation of total income. Say when you are calculating the total income, okay, we should take what are the different incomes for a business is other than the salary income, you get all other incomes. So first let me take income from house property. Since there you see all these incomes of a business or a company, you will get as a in the non-business incomes. So there is no non-business income, that is income from house property. I will take it as nil. Next is taxable income, income from business. Already we have computed how much it is, 7,65,000. Third one is income from capital gain. Say capital gain, we have a long term capital gain, long term capital gain of 1,00,000 rupees. From this long term capital gain, if you read the adjustment B point, there was an unabsorbed capital losses. What is the meaning of capital loss? When you sell a long term capital asset for a loss, that loss is called as capital loss. If you have any such capital losses, you can set off against only the capital gains. And capital losses cannot be set off against any other head of income. Now, we have a long-term capital gain in the previous year 18-19. Any capital losses of belongs to the previous years or preceding to the previous years, we can deduct it. So, brought forward unabsorbed capital loss 40,000 rupees we have. This we have deducted and taken 60,000 rupees. Next, fourth one is income from other sources. Income from other sources. See, income from other sources, we have two incomes because in the problem they have given three non-business incomes. In that long-term capital gain, we have taken under the head income from other sources. The next one is interest on bank deposits. Interest on bank deposits. What is the amount? 30,000. And dividend from Indian company. Dividend from Indian company. See, dividend from Indian company is exempted from taxes as we have learnt in the income tax as well as here also. So therefore, I am writing it as a exempted. Okay guys, now the total income, taxable income from other sources is 30,000. Now, if you take the totals, you will get gross total income. Gross total income.
from this gross total, take the totals of this, you get 8,55,000 rupees. From this, we have to give deductions. Usually, which deduction you will find is, you will find deduction under section ATG. Okay, ATG is nothing but donations. See, there are various types of donations out there. But for us, in the given problem, donation to approved public charitable trust, which qualifies only 50% deduction. How much? 50% deduction comparing to the 10% of gross total income. That means, first what we have to take is, compare 10% of gross total income on 8,55,000. If you calculate 10%, you will get 85,500. Then you compare this with 50% of donation. So 50% of donation is 10,000 rupees. So whichever is lower in these two, whichever is lower will be given as a deduction, that is 10,000. So remaining 8,45,000 is the total income. Got it, guys? See, in this question, the very important is donations we have to take. So donations, how to calculate? Since this is not a qualified of 100% deduction, this qualifies only 50% deduction qualified donation, and we compare this 50% of donation with 10% of gross total income, whichever is lower will be given as a deduction. Now, step number 1 and step number 2 we have done with this. Next is computation of tax liability. Computation of tax liability. See, when you want to calculate tax liability, how do we calculate? First, we take, do we have short-term capital gain? Usually, we provide 15% tax on short-term capital gain. Since we don't have any short-term capital gain, yeah, you can check it here. Not that, here. Second one is long-term capital gain at 20%. Check, is there any long-term capital gain? Yes, we have. On 60,000, 20% is 12,000. Okay. Next is, do we have any casual income? Do we have any casual income? No casual income. If casual income, it would have been there, we could have calculated at 30%. On all other incomes, all other incomes is, see, we have a total income of 8,45,000. From this 8,45,000, we have already calculated taxes on 60,000. We have already calculated taxes on this 60,000 rupees. Then what is the balance is 7,85,000. 7,845 minus 60 is 7,85,000. On this 75,000, we calculate 25%. 7,85,000 into 25%. See, what is the 25% on this is 1,96,250. See, why we are calculating 25% is, assume that the turnover of the company is less than 250 crores. So therefore, we are calculating 25%. So now, the total will be 2,08,250. To this, we should add surcharge. There is no surcharge because your taxable income is less than 1 crore rupees. So therefore, no surcharge will be there. If surcharge is more than 1 crore but less than 250 crores, we would have calculated 7%. If would have more than 10 crores, then 12% surcharge would have calculated. Now let us add the surcharge is nil. This is no income, that is the taxable total income is less than 1 crore. Next is health and education cess. And education cess at 4% on 2,08,250. If you calculate 4%, how much we get is 8,330. So 580, 16, 2,16,000. This is the tax liability of a C company. All of you got it, guys? This is a question for 14 marks. So this is the first question. We are solving it on the in this video after the introduction class. Please, guys. For all the problems, if they have asked for under normal tax provision, suppose if they have not mentioned anything, so they have asked to calculate tax liability, then we have to follow under the normal tax provision. Understood? Suppose if he is clearly given under MAT 115JB, then we calculate in a different way. All of you got it, guys? Because 115JB we have not yet done of any problems. Got it? Okay.